While studying at the University of California, Berkeley in the United States, Masayoshi Son developed an electric dictionary that helped people translate languages. He sold the project to SharpCorp for $1.7 million while studying at the university itself. He worked on another project that gave him $1.5 million. With a total amount of $3.2 million, Son founded SoftBank in 1981. It started off as a company that distributed software, a company that provided a bank of software and thus the name SoftBank. SoftBank may have started out as a software distributor, but it has expanded rapidly. It has also entered into sectors such as telecom, internet, energy, and robotics, among many others. The year 1999 proved to be a tough one for Masayoshi Son. He almost went bankrupt when SoftBank stocks went down by 99% when the dot-com bubble burst. Masayoshi Son lost a staggering $70 billion, the largest loss an individual has ever recorded in history.
And somehow I survived.
But Son worked his way back up to rebuild his business by pursuing Vodafone Japan and turning it into an extremely profitable endeavor. SoftBank's investment journey started way before Vision Fund. One of its biggest investments were made in London-based semiconductor design company Arm. A staggering $34 billion was pumped. Son has also invested in Yahoo and Alibaba. In 2017, SoftBank launched the popular $100 billion technology-focused Vision Fund. The fund comprised of contributions from Apple, Qualcomm, Foxconn, SharpCorp, Abu Dhabi's Mubadala Investment Company and Saudi Arabia Public Investment Fund. Son convinced Saudi Arabia's Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman to invest $45 billion in the Vision Fund. The Vision Fund made SoftBank the star investor of the Silicon Valley and the entire world startup ecosystem. It made investments in iconic companies of the world, including WeWork, Uber, Didi Chuxing, and Flipkart, among many others. Vision, which was considered that of a genius, started getting questioned after a series of incidents. The most iconic companies of the Silicon Valley and SoftBank, WeWork and Uber, failed in their IPOs. While Uber failed to put a convincing show as its stock slipped immediately after listing and is trading below issue price even today, WeWork cancelled its IPO a week before its launch. Overcapitalization is being touted one of the reasons for their failures. Experts started questioning the Japanese conglomerate's strategy of pumping more capital than what the companies require. The stock market did not accept the SoftBank's growth-only and less profitability strategy. Son has been trying to do a lot of damage control ever since. He came up with a rescue package of $9.5 billion for PropTech startup WeWork. According to reports, SoftBank has been telling its portfolio companies to focus on profitability before thinking and planning IPOs. The newly launched Vision Fund 2's future remains uncertain as many of SoftBank's investors are now hesitant to make further investments. Moreover, SoftBank recorded a loss of 704 billion yen in the July-September quarter. All eyes are now on how Son sets the path right.